Hello, folks. This is the Saboteur coming at you from Hillbilly Gaming, playing a little Madden NFL 16 for y'all folks today. All right, we're going to be playing the Dallas Cowboys versus the Miami Dolphins. Two teams that don't play each other on a regular basis. One's in the AFC, one's in the NFC. So they don't play every year, but when they do play, they have some hellacious games. And I remember a few games throughout time, the big Leon Lett game where Dallas was going to the playoffs if they could win the game. And Leon Lett went down there and muffed the punt, gave them the ball, and gave the Dolphins the freaking win. But they've been some big games. They both come out in the 60s, so they've been around a while, so they've had a few games through time. All right, man, this is a nail-biter game that goes right down to the freaking wire. You don't know who's going to win until the last snap of the freaking ball. And I'm telling you straight up, man, don't think you know who's going to win until the last snap, until the clock runs out. Because this is one of them games. It's my favorite game that I've played on Madden so far, the most exciting game I played on Madden all time, including all the other Maddens. And probably as exciting as any game I've ever watched, so... Y'all don't go nowhere. Y'all stick around and watch it till the end. You'll find out it was a pretty good game, man. All right, we got the ball first. We're moving up and down the line. We snapped the ball. So we got to try to play a little offense. I used the Dallas Cowboys first couple games out. Romo, like in real life, threw a bunch of freaking pickoffs, man. So I end up changing other teams. I get a chance to win. Coming off of a 3 or 4 game win streak. People keep quitting around left and right. When you get ahead, they'll quit on you. And that kind of sucks, but that's the problem with all online gaming. People don't like to lose. They start getting behind, they will quit. So let's go out here and let's have a little fun. Let's play a little football. All right, we got a Romo, who I just mentioned. I mean, he's an accurate quarterback. He's a good quarterback. I was on the bandwagon when he first started, man. When he made the big bucks, he kind of started choking around a little bit. He's an off and on kind of quarterback, so it depends on what kind of mood he's in. If he got laid last night, everything factors into Romo. But let's go ahead and watch him play. They got a big offensive line out in front of him, so let's go out here and let's tear these sons of bitches up. At least give it hell while we're at it. He's so competitive. We got some good fans in Cowboys, dude, man. Jerry Jones bought the team years ago. And he's a wannabe coach, man. Old Jerry Jones, kind of a backseat driver for the coaches on this team. Old Jimmy Johnson, though, he didn't take no shit off of Jerry Jones. He came out and he was the boss. But anyhow, we're going to get it on. Score 0-0. We're still in the first quarter, and we're driving the ball down the field. Come on, Romo, show us what you're made of. Show us why you make all that freaking money. Well, Romo, though, I think he had a pretty decent year last year. I didn't watch, but my nephew told me he had one of his best years in a while. I quit watching, man, because Romo was always fucking losing in the big game. I've become to expect Dallas Cowboys to win, and then they started choking in the big games and shit, so I ended up giving up football for a little while. But I'm back, guys. I went out and bought me Madden NFL 16. I went out here, and I had a blast with it, you know, so I decided... I'm going to go ahead and start watching football this year again, get back into my team. I've been checking out the rosters. So I've came back to the Dallas Cowboys. I've used some other teams, but now I'm trying Dallas again. I'm going to come out here and see if I can win with them. They're my favorite team. I hate to play the game and not use my favorite team. Romo pissed me off a little bit early, but I'm back. This time he did me good, man. He came out and threw for 90% and 0 interceptions. I ain't giving away no score because the other guy plays awesome too. I mean, so it turns out to be a hell of a game where we keep coming up with some big plays when we have to. But I'm driving the ball down the field right off the bat. I'm not sure who caught that. I know it wasn't Bryant, the big superstar from OSU. Williams is 85, so it wasn't him. I'm not sure. I think that was the third string receiver. But that's all right. It don't matter who it was. We're moving the ball. So looks like we're coming into a run play, so let's try to run it off to the left. Boom, bitches. And he gets nowhere. 3 or 4 guys come up and gang tackle his ass. Some bitch felt like he was in prison. He done dropped the freaking soap. But anyhow, we come up to the next play. We're going to try a little pass here. All right, let's see what we can't do. Second down. We're backing up. Guy coming in motion. We back up, running it off the outside. For some reason, I let him run that play instead of just taking over from the start of the run play. And he went deep outside. It was good to go inside. I don't know where the hell he was freaking going. But I won't let him take over no more. I'll control my running back from the line of scrimmage and the snap of the ball. So we didn't get it done there, but we still got another play to try. So you know we're going to come out with the pass here and try to get the ball into the end zone. So either that or we'll end up having to go for a field goal if we don't get it done. So let's get it done. Homo backs up, throws the ball on the knee. But there's two guys there to take him down. We didn't get the freaking end zone. We got to kick the field goal, but that's part of football. The Saboteur kicks his field goals. He punched it on the fourth down when he's supposed to. You know, I play by the books, guys. I mean, I don't want these guys to get out here and go for it on every fourth down, throw the ball every freaking down. I try to keep a real NFL feel to it. And my opponent here, he's the same way. He comes out and he plays by the books. He kicks it when he's supposed to. He tries to mix it up, run and pass. And it turns out to be a hell of a game. If you try to keep it like the NFL, you have some NFL-style games. So, I mean, I've had a lot of people come out here and throw the ball every freaking down, including fourth down. Go for it every fourth down and end up quitting on you. And I've had some, a couple of them that stayed around. That's just the way they play, man. It's just a game. It ain't real life. It's 13. They can play it however they want to. But I get a little upset when people quit. I mean, because once you're used to starting a game and playing for 20, 30 minutes with somebody and then get behind a touchdown and quit, I hate it. But it's part of the online gaming and any online game. So I guess I just got to do like everyone else and freaking deal with it. All right, here we go, guys. Dolphins got the ball. We got 3 points, so they're going to drive it down the field and see if they can't match us or do a little better. Let's see what happens.
You fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it.
All right, I'll be quiet here every once in a while. I got my – so you can hear the game, too. I got it set where it's
that'll be second and
lets me be heard a little bit louder than the game, I hope, because sometimes – it's hard editing, man. Well, I mean, anybody who's got a YouTube channel, they'll tell you if you're using Agata. And there's a lot of people that's got it figured out, but I just got my Agata so I could use it for playing on Xbox because Xbox saves sucks. You only get 5-minute saves. PlayStation 4 saves are 15-minute saves, and I like them a lot better. If you're going to play a game like Madden, which lasts an hour, you ain't going to be able to use PlayStation 4 saves anyhow. So I had to finally get me an Agata. I got me a Snowball mic. Right here, I'm starting to freak out thinking that dude's quitting because a lot of people have been quitting on me, but he ain't quitting, guys. He'll be back. But anyhow, I finally broke down and got me an Agata and a good little PC computer. Got me a Snowball mic. Got set up to have a real, you know, a real YouTube channel with some quality videos to go with my quality commentary and my average gameplay. Now, I'm a pretty good game at gameplay. I'm not the best out there, but I give it hell. And I play a variety of different games, so, I mean, it's hard to be the master. And like they say, I'm a jack of all trades, master of none, because I play every freaking game out there, guys. If you check out my channel, it's got everything from Project Cars to the Battlefield, Call of Duty games, Grand Theft Auto, golf, baseball, football, Minecraft, everything you can think of. If it's a game, I play it. So, I'm not the best at every freaking game, man. These guys have just played nothing but Battlefield, and they're pretty damn good at Battlefield. I mean, they got channels that are nothing but Hardline, Battlefield Hardline. But I got a variety of different games, so, I mean, if you like a variety of different games, I think you'll enjoy my channel. But let's get it on. Let's talk a little football here. Getting a little carried away with the YouTube channel. I'm forgetting about these Miami Dolphins driving down the field. All right, we shut his ass down there and put the game tackle on him. So now we're shutting him down pretty well. It's a defensive-offensive game. He's going into the hurry up. All right, let's see what he does, guys. You see what I'm in? I'm in a zone man coverage. He snaps up. Did you see that freaking pass? This dude's pretty good, man. He catches his guy when he's right on his route. He don't mess up. He sees his guy cutting to the inside. He puts it between the ball, between him and his guy, where the cornerback don't have that good a chance to make a play on it. So the dude's pretty good.
That was a big gainer.
We're having a pretty damn good game here. Even though I'm up by three, I know it ain't freaking over, and you can know it ain't over to you. The game comes right down to the wire, and it ain't really a defensive game. I mean, it's a mixture of a defensive and an offensive game. It ain't low scoring, but it ain't high scoring. And there's some offense and some defense it's going on the whole game. So I hope you enjoy it, folks. Rush. I know I sure enjoy playing it. But he's driving the ball right down the field on my ass.
Set up screen. Jay Ajaya.
All right, that was a good play, too. He's starting to sock together a few good plays on me. Come on, guys. Freaking tackle. Make a play.
People catching the balls. Catch it cleanly. Also, catch it and break a tackle.
All right, here we go. He's got the ball down on my side now. He's starting to bring it up. I'll show you what defense I'm in. And offense. I try to show you my plays between each play so you can kind of get an idea what defense I'm in, what offense I'm in, so you can look at his side and kind of look at it. That line was blitzed his ass and made him eat dirt. Eat that mud pie, you son of a bitch. Put him back on his back. So here we go again. He's doing the hurry up. He's trying to hurry up down and score on the clock. So let's get it on, folks. Yeah, as I was saying, we put him in the dirt again, but he got the ball off and landed on the ground. I hope the sound syncs up with the game, man, because I'm narrating over a video. I had an awesome game and I narrated over it. I usually just do it live while I'm playing. I talk while I'm playing the game live, but a lot of people end up quitting if they get a touchdown or something behind. They know I'm live streaming or it's going to be on YouTube. They quit, so I just went out here and played around a little bit without the mic and had a great freaking game. I decided to go ahead and put it up on YouTube for y'all folks. But I'm hoping the sound and the video come through at the same time. I've been editing this son of a bitch for a few hours already. I got it down once where I was really happy with my commentary.
This has been a long time.
Went back to check it out, and I was happy with my video quality. Everything had come together. And then I watched it all the way through there, halfway through, and I noticed that my sound didn't sync with my gameplay. And somewhere along the line, I gained a little ground on the gameplay from the sound. I lost a little ground. And ended up, I was talking about shit that had already happened or something. So I had to go back and redo it all again. I've done edited this video for 3 or 4 hours. So I'm hoping this time it's going to come together. I got my fingers crossed. Say a little prayer, man. Just hope for the freaking best. You don't realize how much time goes into editing. When you just watch a video, and I didn't really either, man. I used to just sock them up on PlayStation 4, push share it in square, save that son of a bitch, then I might send it to the gallery thing there, or the where you talk over them and shit. I go in there and talk over it if I had to, and send it right on through to YouTube. It was just simple as cake, man. But I got me an Elgato now, so I got to figure out how to do it like the big boys if I'm going to have a YouTube channel that people are going to want to watch. They want to see top quality video. Still figuring out my text and my thumbnails and all that stuff. But, I mean, that shit comes as you go along. You figure it out by trial and error. So I've been having a lot of error and a lot of trial. But now we're starting to get it figured out. Guy's got the ball up here. He does a rollout. Throws it back, freaking tight end, blocked for a second, went out, was wide open, pulled my freaking team all the way, and he got him a good touchdown there. So, all right, we got a 6-3 game, fixing to be a 7-3 game. So the dude drove all the way down the field to put some points on the board, man. We got a good game going. Right now it's a defensive game, but you really can't say that because we've been putting up some yards and driving the ball. But he ended up shutting me down at the end zone. I ended up letting him have his seven, but it's not how you start, it's how you finish, and that's why there's 4 quarters to football. Like any game, I say it in all the games I play, it's not how you start, it's how you finish, because you can go out there and do good early and still lose the game, man. You can't just worry about the battles, you got to win the war, and we got 4 quarters, and we got a long time in this game before it's over, so don't give up, folks. It's going to be a good game. It comes right down to the freaking wire. The last play of the game is going to decide the winner.
But
now it's time for me to come out and show my offense off. So come on, offense, come out and make something happen to my ass. Like I said, I got Romo, I got some good receivers in Bryant and Williams with the best tight end in the freaking game, Witten. So let's go out here and let's make something happen. Randall's a young running back, but he's a good running back, I guess. I got all kinds of time, and I end up throwing it out to the tight end out there. He makes the catch, but goes out of bounds. So we're moving the ball, not big time, but we're trying to move it down the field. I don't want to get greedy because, like I was saying before, man, I need Romo. Son of a bitch throw seven pickoffs if I get out there and make him try too hard. So I'm trying to play smart, trying to pick the open guys. Because Romo's pretty accurate, just so you don't make him force shit. Because like in real life, he forces shit. Look at old Big Wit, and he's excited. I hope that voice is coming along with the game, man. I'll check it out before I put it up. But I hope I don't have to do it again. I shouldn't have to. But look at that. There was a fumble. Nope. Their D has been playing pretty damn good, man. They've been holding me back. So let's see if my D can't come out here while I still got the freaking ball. Come on, what are you talking about? You're already playing D, man. You still got the freaking ball. Come on, Romo. Let's move the ball down the field, man. Let's mix it up. Looks like I'm getting a little pass happy here. All right. Got a little pass happy. Through an incomplete pass. It's alright. It's not how you start, it's how you finish, Romo. Get up off your back. Get back up here and call another freaking play.
After the incomplete pass, it's third.
Calling another freaking pass. Well, you can tell here I got a little pass happy here. My defense, I mean, I'm about to give up on the run a little bit because, I mean, it's hard. People shut you down to run. But, I mean, you just got to stay persistent with it, like anything. So I'm backing up the pass again. What freaking happens? A freaking fumble and a freaking touchdown. So now it ain't looking good for the Cowboys or the Saboteurs. We're losing 14-3. But like I say, it ain't over yet. The fat lady ain't sung. Roseanne Barr, set your ass back down up there. You wait till it's over before you come down and sing. And nobody give up because the Saboteurs ain't giving up. And no matter if I win or lose, I'll play it to the freaking end. I hate quitters. But you know the Saboteurs ain't going to quit. I mean, four of the games I got up on YouTube, two of them were freaking losses, but I'll play to the bitter end, win or lose, man. Losing ain't what makes you a loser, man. A quitter is more of a loser in my mind. I mean, you can win with grace and you can lose with style and grace too. So let's get out here and let's finish this game up. I'm down by 11. Some of the people I've played against online would have already freaking quit, but I'm not quitting. I ain't giving up, and I guarantee you by the end of the game, I'll be back up there and it'll come down to the freaking wire. The reason I know that is because I've already freaking played it. If I was live commentating, I'd probably be getting a shake. Oh, hell, boy, it looks like it's over, but it's not live commentating. I played the game already, so I know I come back. I know it's a hell of a game, so you just gotta wait and see.
Burn the first of their three timeouts right here.
Breaking huddle at the 35. All
right, come on, Cowboys. You get the ball back again. This is your big chance to come back and redeem yourself, Romo. Well, he ain't through no freaking pickoffs. He got a fumble, but hell, the offensive line let him come through. But what's that? What's that? Freaking touchdown, man. All right, we got a touchdown now. So we came back. We can be down by four, or we can go for two. It looks like we're going for two, folks. We're in it to win it. So we're going to come out here and try to make this a three-point game or a field goal to either tie it up. So we're going for two now instead of waiting for later. All right, come on, guys. Cross your fingers. Quick, get your panties out of a knicker over there and get ready for some freaking football. All right, let's snap the ball. Let's see what happens. Guy going out in motion there.
So from 2 yards
they throw it to the inside, and we get the two-point conversion to Whitney. So we're on a roll, folks. It's just a three-point game now. It's anybody's freaking ball game. And I sure hope this sound is syncing up, man, because, I mean, I spent an hour a while ago narrating this thing. Got it done. Was happy with the quality of the video. I had some good commentary, I thought. I was happy with it. And I got back watching the thing before I uploaded it. And freaking the sound wasn't matching the video. It was off like 4 or 5 seconds. So I didn't send it through. If it happens this time, I might just have to send it through. You might have to bear with it. Because I spent 4 or 5 hours on this video. I mean, I finished this game 3 or 4 hours ago. And I'm still trying to edit it and get it ready for uploading to YouTube. And I got to spend 15 hours uploading some of this after I get it ready. So it's a full-time job, man, running this YouTube. So if you ever decide to start a YouTube channel and you want to make videos, make sure you do what you like, man, because it's a lot of work. So make sure you like what you're doing. But I love gaming, and I love bringing videos out here to interact with people, let people watch my videos, interact what they think of my gaming. So I mean, I like it a lot, so I'm willing to sit back and do the editing.
play.
Now I got to play a little defense. He's going to be tackled. Boy, sucker runs right a lot of those screens out there. Yard line. The Dolphins. That's one thing he's good at, screens.
They have two remaining.
I ain't got enough patience for screens, though, man. You got to back up and let their offensive line or their defensive line through while your offensive line sneaks up there, three or four guys in front of your running back. You got to be patient, and patience is a virtue that I don't have. So I'm not much of a screen player. This guy moves the ball, man. He's efficient, ain't he, moving down the field. I mean, he puts the ball in between him and his receiver and keeps a cornerback, my cornerback's defense on the outside there. So He's pretty efficient moving the ball down the field. But the Saboteur, he keeps coming back in big spurts, man. I might not be as efficient nickel and diamond down the field, but I come back and I'm there for the whole duration of the game. Yeah, football's about ready to start, ain't it? High school's already started. College has started. Now the NFL is getting ready to start any week now. I think it's next week they start. So it's finally here, guys. And I'm going to watch a lot of it this year. I'm going to get back on the Dallas Cowboy bandwagon. The original reason I'm a Dallas Cowboy fan, because in my area, I'm from Oklahoma. In my area, Fox, all they show on Sundays, the Dallas Cowboys week by week. If the Cowboys are playing, it's what's on Fox. So that's my team. I mean, I guess if I live, you know, somewhere else or they showed a different team every week, I might be a fan of a different team. But Dallas Cowboys is who I'm a fan of. And holy shit, that was a hell of a sack. Come on, Romo, shake it off, man. He's up there giving his big salute to the crowd. Screw you, bastard, you cocky son of a bitch. We're going to come back and we're going to stuff it to you. All right, I guess that's the end of the first half. This is the start of the third quarter. Looks like we got to kick the ball off, and the score is 14-11. It's a three-point ball game.
All
right, I kicked that son of a bitch all the way back to Texas. I guess we're in Texas, so I kicked it all the way back to the backside of Texas. So he ain't getting to field the ball. He's going to bring it out to the 20, and that's where my defense is going to start. Yeah, all right, it's been a pretty good game for y'all folks so far. Sorry about that. It's been a long night. It's been a pretty good game for y'all folks so far. Hope y'all ain't getting bored. Because, I mean, it's just halftime. We got another half to go, and it's just as exciting as the first half. All right. No, I had to kick the ball first, and he's got the ball first. He's 3 points up, and he's taking the ball down the field. He's going to start off a little running, but I'm set for the run. I knew he was going to run. So I was blitzing everybody in the kitchen sink. Now he's coming up in a hurry up, and I still got set for a blitz, man. So I've been playing a lot of man zone blitz, or zone blitz, and man blitz. Been trying to mix it up a lot. But I try not to drop zone too much with this guy because he's pretty efficient, he's pretty accurate. And he lets his guys just find the open spot in the zone and just wait. My defense ain't putting enough pressure on him. So I guess I'm going to go with the zone right now. Looks like zone blitz, so maybe I'll get a little pressure on his ass and he'll mess up. Let's see what happens.
They're setting up screen.
Well, I had the pressure on him, but he had another damn screen play.
That's what you
he waited
to
the last second, threw the ball, and had three or four blockers out in front of his running back. So my hat's off to this dude, man. He knows his freaking football, and I love games so like this. I love getting out here playing with people that know the game and know football and get out here and have some realistic football games, man. This is just like watching the game on a Sunday afternoon. Big game between Miami and Dallas. I don't think they scheduled to play each other this year. But this is what the game would be like. This will be what I'd want it to be like. You know, I like it where they get out there and you never know what's going to happen right down to the very end. And that's the kind of game this one is. So he's moving the ball pretty efficiently. My defense is bend but don't break, and that's their motto. Looks like I'm in a zone blitz here.
With a dime defense.
I audible it up my defense to a man zone, and he's running the ball right up the middle, but we stopped his
ass. Nice run that time. When you run the football like this.
Yeah, y'all guys feel free to like, man. Drop a like if y'all like this video. Comment, man. I love to interact with the people that watch my videos, know what they think about them. You know, comment over this video what you think, or football in general, or whatever you want to say. I like to interact with people. Hell, feel free to subscribe, guys. It only takes a second to subscribe. You're allowed to subscribe to 1,000 channels, man. So if you ain't used up all your subscriptions and you like my videos, go ahead and just reach over there real quick and subscribe. It only takes a second. Just go to subscribe and click on it. You're a subscriber. That makes me a fan of yours. No, I'm just joking. But anyhow, I'm a new and up-and-coming channel, man. I got 315 subscribers right now. I'd like to hit 1,000 subscribers. I don't plan on never being rich, having no 100,000 subscribers or nothing like that. But I like to get up to 1,000 subscribers and have more people watch my videos so I can interact with more people. Because I really enjoy it. So I hope y'all enjoy my videos too. But anyway, let's get on back to football and quit talking about YouTube and channels and all that shit. Let's get out here and have a little fun with a little Madden NFL 16. Cowboys against the Dolphins. All right, he still got the ball. The score is still the same. The Dolphins will take the snap. So let's get out here and play a little defense. Come on, B. He took off running up the middle. Gang tackle his ass. He still got a few yards out of the run. I mean, this guy's moving the ball. I mean, he's got no problem with moving the ball. But I'm staying, trying to stay right there with him, so let's see what happens. Yeah, I'm excited for Dallas Cowboys season to kick off, man. And let me know who your favorite teams are if you watch this and you're a football fan. Just drop a comment who your favorite team is and what you're expecting out of them this year, or who you expect to go to Super Bowl. Hell, this Madden game, they came out with their own little prediction of Super Bowl 50 being Pittsburgh Steelers and I think it was the Seattle Seahawks. I mean, that wouldn't be no surprise. Both those two teams are good teams, so it might happen. I don't know, we'll have to wait and see. Did you see that freaking hit? Yeah, that was a big time hit, man. Flipped him up in the air like a wrestling star. Right there is where I noticed earlier on the first time I did this video, and I went back through it to watch it before I uploaded it to YouTube. That's where I noticed that my sound was off from my gameplay, man, because it showed that play, and it took like 5 or 6 seconds before I said something about it. So, well, I'm hoping this time it comes through right. I'm about to get tired of this game, man. I love the game, but I hate that to sit back and edit and edit over and over. Dude went for a long-ass field goal and missed it. So now that's all right. He went for the long field goal. He didn't get it. So now it's time for the Cowboys to come back out on the field.
And they just missed it.
Let him strut off the field first. All right, here we go, guys. We're going to move the ball down the field and see if we can't come down here and at least get this freaking field goal, get this sucker tied up. I'd rather have a touchdown, but we got to go out and make something happen. Start off with a little running play, try to keep it balanced. Randall, I mean, he's no Williams, man. Cowboys lost some big players, and Williams, running back, and Demarcus Ware, the big tight end, defensive end, hybrid. He's going to go to the Pro Bowl. You know, Ware's going to go to the Pro Bowl. He's one of the best blitzers out there. I mean, and his game's pretty consistent across the board, not just blitzing. But he's also, I mean, steadied up against the run a little bit. And he's a pretty good all-over player, man, all-around player. I think he plays for the Denver Broncos now. Williams went to the Philadelphia Eagles. Philadelphia Eagles, man, I might root for them a little bit this year too, man. They got the
third down on the way.
The two big OU players, Sam Bradford and Williams, man, two big number one draft picks from Oklahoma. So I'm hoping to see them do good. I'm going to root for Williams and the quarterback over there a little bit. Hopefully they'll do good. Look at that shit, boy. He blitzed me right off the back end. Luckily I didn't cough that damn ball up. He come got me unevaded to the quarterback, slammed me in the back. It's a wonder he didn't fumble, but Romo held on to the ball. Thank you, Romo. Let's get it on.
They're set to punt it away now.
All right, we're going to go ahead and punt this son of a bitch. I mean, I play by the rules. I punt it when I'm supposed to on fourth down. I don't go for that shit. I think we're starting the fourth quarter now. Yep, we're starting the fourth quarter. We're going to punt it to them. We're still down by three, but we still got the whole fourth quarter. We just got to continue to play a little defense, and we're in this son of a bitch. The Cowboys and the Saboteurs are in it to win it, folks. We're going to play it right down to the wire. Damn, I thought I got a muff punt there, but I didn't. He's got the ball, so let's see what he can do with it. He's been moving the ball consistently, too. I mean, he's been passing and running, been running some screens. letting his receivers, you know, break
down
and catching them on their breaks where he's throwing the ball pretty efficiently. Here he comes back out with the screen again, but I'm getting ready for him now. I'm getting a little wise to his screens. He's ran two or three of them so far before that one. So I'm starting to get a little wise to him, start to set up for him. So right now I'm set, looks like I'm set in a zone blitz, man. I'm bringing some linebackers. Unless I audible right there, he's going in the runs, and I've bought every linebacker I freaking had and dropped him back in the back.
Easy call. Be safe. Put the pressure on the other team to make the plays.
Yeah, if you haven't checked out my channel before and you're not a subscriber and you're just watching this video, go give my channel a look, see what you think, man. We got a big variety of games. Everything from all the Call of Duty, Battlefield, Grand Theft Auto.
Looking at third down.
We got basketball, baseball, football, golf. We got Project Cars, even Minecraft, man. We got a little bit of everything. So I'm the jack of all trades, master of none. I try to have decent gameplay with decent commentary.
And
try to have a little fun with it, man. That's the main thing. If you ain't having no fun, why the hell you doing it? Saboteur gets out here and just tries to have a little fun. And hopefully it's fun for y'all to watch as well, because I have fun playing the games and I have fun making my videos. The editing gets me tweaked a little bit there, gets under my skin, but that's just part of it. I mean, the better quality videos you're going to have, you're going to have to learn how to edit. So, I mean, I'm just now starting to learn on a young channel. I only took about 3 months old with 300 subscribers, so I'll get better, guys, I promise. My videos will be better quality. My commentary will get a little bit more relaxed. And I'm starting to relax a little bit on the commentary. When I first started, it was a little tougher. Now I just get out there and have fun, talk about whatever the hell I want to talk about, and hope people enjoy the video. But we got the ball right now. No, they got the ball. Sorry about that. They got the ball and tried to throw a little screen out to the wide receiver, and I was set on it with double cornerbacks. So I'm getting wise to the screens. They work really good early. He's going to have to go away from him because the Cowboys are looking for him every down now or in the right situations. But he comes right back with that underneath shit, man. He's a pretty efficient player, man. He knows his football. He gets his receivers on their routes just right when they're cutting, right on their cut. Don't give the cornerback a chance to get the ball. He puts the ball in between him and his receiver, and the cornerbacks ain't got a good chance to break on it, or linebackers, whoever. In that situation, it was a linebacker. But the dude's pretty good, man. My hat's off to him. This is one of the best games I've played on Madden. Definitely the most exciting game I've played on Madden so far. I mean, it's coming down to the wire right now. But it ain't over yet, folks. He's got the lead. He's driving the ball. We're in the fourth quarter. But don't count your chickens before you hatch, man. It ain't over until it's over. And it ain't over until the fat lady sings. And Roseanne Barr, I done told her to sit her ass down and wait till the end of the game before she tries to come out singing and make her opinion known. Anyhow, he does a rollout, hits his receiver. It's a good play. It's starting to look pretty scary for me. He's winning 14-11. He's inside the red zone. Everybody knows that watches football. When you get inside the red zones where it gets tightened up a little bit, defense is a little stronger because you don't got as much of the field to work with. So we got to play a little red zone defense and try to hold him to at least a field goal.
Let's see how clever he's going
to
be.
All right, come on, D. He runs the ball up the middle. He's trying to run it, trying to run the clock. Getting down to halfway through the fourth quarter to the nitty-gritty. He's trying to run the clock out, put some points on the board, and take this win home. He's already smelling blood, so he thinks he's just going to put down the throttle on my throat to try to make it and come out with his screen again. But I told you, folks, I'm watching his screens. I'm ready for him. So that ain't going to work, bro. You're going to have to come up with something different. He's out here at the end zone. I think he's got a third and goal right here. I'm not sure. I'm narrating. This is a little bit screen. I got to see the game, so I can't really see the stats that good unless it pops him out on the field. But anyhow, he's up here trying to drive it in and trying to get the win. But it ain't going to happen, folks. I'm not going to give up that easy. I promise you it's going to come down to the last seconds. And even if he scores, it ain't over. It ain't over until Roseanne Barr comes out and sings her victory song. Will she be singing for the Cowboys or the Dolphins? Oh, Roseanne Barr probably going to sue my ass after she watches my games. I'm always saying it ain't over until Roseanne Barr sings. I hope she don't watch my videos. If I ever get famous, she might see my ass, but I don't ever expect to get famous, folks. I'm just out here having fun, trying to make some videos for people to watch. If you watch them, you watch them. If you don't, you don't.
The kick is good.
That was a good hold. Good kick.
All right, he got the touchdown. So now he's sitting at 17, or no, he got the field goal. And he's sitting at 17-11, man. It's a six-point game.
The Cowboys.
I ain't got too much damn time left. I'm under the two-minute warning here. So we'll see what happens. I'm going to come out swinging. I'm definitely going to come out swinging. I ain't got much time to run the freaking ball no more. So, Randall, go ahead and take your shoes off. Well, no, you stay out there and do a little blocking. But I'm fixing to try to use that big tight, them two big wide receivers, Bryant and Williams. Let that ball roll on by. So, I'm bringing it out to 20. Down to like a minute and a half, 80 yards to go for the win. Can I do it? I'm in the Hail Mary, and I'm going to be throwing this ball around, folks. It's going high, so I'm hoping my guys can jump up and grab it and get me a big freaking play. But I'm going to need more than one. I'm going to need at least two or three big plays to get in the end zone. So here we go. Let's see what happens. All right, let me do a little hot route in here. Hot route and wide out, do it out in case I need a drop-off guy. No, I cut him across the middle, but I threw it up high. And look who came down with it. What a catch, man. What a freaking catch. That's how come Bryant makes the big bucks for catches like that, man. And he pulls them off in real life, and he pulls them off in the game. When I got to go deep, I usually try to go to him. But I'm not afraid to go to Williams on the other side either, man. He come down with some big catches, too. He might not get paid as much money as Bryant does, but I'm sure he loves to play just as much and likes to make the big plays when he gets the chance. And who do I throw it to? Williams. Touchdown, folks. Take that, you son of a bitch. All right, I'm playing against a guy called Peace Clouds. And now I guarantee you,
convert on the extra point and take the lead here in the late going.
Yeah.
Add good push.
Yeah, push clouds. So you know he's ahead, folks. His head's up in the clouds. So I'm hoping he just smoked a big one and he's fixing to fall apart here. But he's got a little bit of time to come back. I'm up by 1 point. Let's see what can happen, guys. Anything can still happen. Told you the game wasn't going to be over until the last seconds. We wasn't going to know who was going to win until it was over. So let's keep it going. We still got a little bit of excitement left for y'all folks today.
Able to move past the
all right, we got him tackled back there. He came out and brought the ball out. So he's got it at his 20. Now it's up to him. He's got 80 yards to freaking drive. I had 80 yards to drive and came out with two big plays from Hail Mary. He got me a touchdown. So now it's his turn to see if he can pull it off too. So here we go, folks.
Take a short gain if that's what the defense is.
I hope y'all enjoying this game, man. I really enjoyed playing it. I really enjoyed the commentary the first time, and I had to re-commentate it. But I've enjoyed the commentary the second time, man. I mean, I love it. I love getting out here and playing. I love talking through the games. I mean, you got to be able to get out here and talk because it's an hour freaking game. And I usually do it live, man. I'm probably going back to doing it live after having to narrate this one twice. I'll probably go back to doing it live, especially if I end up still lagging behind or the sound not matching up with the video. I'll probably go back to just playing it live. But if you play it live, man, people will hear you on the other side and they'll end up quitting. So I guess I'm just going to have to gamble on it. I guess if they're playing good, they won't quit. But if they start getting behind a little bit and they know you're live streaming or you're putting this up on YouTube, they'll end up quitting anyway. Anyhow, I got defense, man. Let me drop back, play some zone. I know he's going to be throwing it deep. Time's about to run out. He's got to make something happen if he's going to make it happen. So I'm just going to back up here, play some D, play a little prevent defense style. What are you going
to
do, guy? Third and 10, you better make something happen. All right, I know he's going deep, but all he needs is 10 yards to get the next play, so he might not go for the home run. Let's see what happens, folks. Booyah. Pick off. Look at this shit. Who's got the ball? Well, guys, I think I see Roseanne Barr moving down to the mic, fixing to sing the Dallas Cowboys theme song, because it looks like the Saboteur and the Dallas Cowboys have locked this shit up. But it ain't over yet. I should be running out the clock right here so I can what the hell am I doing? I'm trying to go in. I'm going to the special teams, trying to find where you just kneel the ball down. I couldn't find it. It used to be in special teams on the Madden I used to play. So I'm just going to go in the goal line and run the ball. Hope my guy don't fumble it. Because if you fumble it, that means that other team's got a chance to recover it and run it in for end zone. And I told you it wasn't going to be over till the end, so let's see what happens here. He tucked me down there, called his timeout, and was trying to hold me. Apologize about the voice, guys, but like I said, I just talked through this video a while ago. It's the second time I talked through this video, and I'm hoping this one comes through. Actually, I like the commentary a little better on the first one, but what can you do if it don't match the sound, don't match the game? Who wants to sit there and watch it? But what happens? Freaking touchdown. Randall finally come through with a big one. You dance it out, brother. You deserve it. They get a little crazy on the dances and shit on football. Get a little crazy with their ass slapping. But that's the game, guys. It was a hell of a game. Hope you enjoyed watching it. Thanks for watching.
The point after try is in the books. The Dolphins are back deep waiting for the kick. Landry's got it on the return. And he will not score. This game is over.
Is every win sweet, or are the close ones that much more satisfying than just blowing someone out for 60 minutes?
Well, the close ones are more satisfying because the tension is there longer. And the longer you're under tension, when it finally comes to fruition, you win, it just makes it that much more exciting, Jim.
For Phil Simms and all the crew at EA Sports, Jim Nance saying so long for now.